for you need not change yourself, cannot change yourself. Only shall you recognize who you are, and all else will become purified, for all the thoughts, all the perceptions, all the expressions of the one reality are pure in and of themselves. You need not do anything. You need not fight against the appearances within this illusion called Maya, a covering over the false sense of self, covering over the reality of who and what you really are, of what this really is. For this is you. This is none other than you, the pure manifest being here and now, in this room, in this world, in this reality. So give up. Surrender the desire. Surrender the need to change, the need to be different than you are. Instead, seek to find yourself. For only when you experience yourself will you know that you are pure, that you are perfect, that nothing needs to be changed, ever. Ever has anything needed to be changed from who you are. For you are a divine manifestation of God, created in the image of God, perfect from the very beginning and perfect from the very end. Let not your thoughts of separation, let not your thoughts of temptation to be different, to satisfy the needs of those around you, the needs that have been expressed from others to you throughout your entire lifetime here, wanting you to fulfill their agenda, to fulfill their wishes and their needs of you in this world. For they have asked and they have told you to fulfill their wishes, their desires, all the while leading you more and more deeply into the external manifest world, never at all realizing who you are in this world, in this place. For when you realize yourself, when you experience and see and feel the divine energy that you are, you will realize that no work need be done. That all work is on a superficial level of reality, a layer of false selves that exists outside who and what you really are, the pure and divine energy, the pure and divine consciousness of yourself. For all techniques, all energy work techniques, stem from belief in a false sense of self, seeking to improve upon what already is perfect. Can what is perfect ever be made better? That is a question we ask you. But before you answer it, look inside yourself to find yourself. Experience yourself. And in that place of perfect peace, that place of perfect oneness, where no thoughts arise, that place of perfect beingness. Is there a desire? Is there a desire to change oneself? Is there a desire to be different? Seek this place. Find this answer for yourself. And all distractions in the external world will fall away. For you will know yourself to be pure and perfect just as you are, just as is experiential here. For the imperfections exist only in your mind, only in the thoughts that you have been told throughout your entire life. Knowing your perfection, experiencing your perfection as self, as contentment, as peace, as love, as bliss. What is there to be added to this? What can possibly be added to a conscious experience of universal oneness, oneness with all things. For only a judging mind, only an egoic mind, can judge and seek to change that which it deems to be wrong to that which it deems to be right. Look at your life. Look at the life you have led up to this moment in divine time. Look at it. Understand that what you have deemed to be wrong later became right. What you have deemed to change has become right, but may now be wrong. For you yourself are an evolving soul, experiencing the divine manifestations here, continually adding to oneself, to the idea of oneself, in this manifest creation, all the while lost, all the while unaware of who and what you really are, as a perfect spiritual being, as a consciousness with no thoughts of separation, no feelings of separation, no awareness of separation. So I ask you, when you experience yourself as this oneness, as this divine being, what is there to change? The sages of old have asked this very question. They have arrived at the same answer that you will. For there is nothing to change when there are no desires present. No desires to be different, no experiences of suffering in a realm called yourself, called who and what you really are. So experience that. And give up the practices of modification, give up the practices of purification, give up all practices that seek to create in a linear time sequence, and instead experience yourself as you really are. Experience yourself as consciousness. Experience the divine core of you, yourself, that purified energy structure, that purified energy consciousness that we know as you, the I am, who and what we really are. Now, looking into this manifest experience, this manifest realm we call life, we see a myriad of forms, a myriad of energy structures, a myriad of vibrational manifestations here and now, all of them stemming forth from the same, apparently invisible, all the while experiential, source of life. For these energies may appear multifaceted, may appear numerous and random, chaotic at times, yet all the while appearing different. Different from each other, no exact replicas, for no drops of water are ever the same, no snowflakes bear the same pattern. How can this be? How can all the experiences of life, all the expressions of life, everything existing within our consciousness look so different? Look so entirely different, yet be rising from the same source, from the same source of life. How can this experience of oneness exist within the duality and the multiplicity of life?